What is it? Something? Thank you. Keep it up.
Sup?
You were calling for me, Father. What is it?
We've just received an urgent message from Captain Leston, the commander of the Elven Knights from Welland. It sounds like he's seeing a lot of Imperial activity in Claval Crags.
You think they're preparing for an attack?
We can't say for certain, but it sounds like another group of Wellandine Knights are locked in a standoff in the mountains to the east. We're worried the Empire might try to catch them in a pincer strike, but the Knights can't risk an immediate maneuver. So, I would have your team move in and strike before the enemy can finish their preparations.
I understand. Where is the enemy based?
The commander will brief you himself. Sir Leston, if you wouldn't mind.
Of course. Allow me.
For this operation, I ask that you look to Sir Leston for further instructions. Good luck to you all.
Yes, Father. You can count on me.
By your leave, Your Majesty. Now, our circumstances are as follows.
Leston, my man! Long time no see!
Magnum. Still alive, I see.
Jeez, man. Cold as ice. Is that any way to greet an old buddy?
I was not summoned for my proficiency in greetings, Agnum. I am here to conduct a war.
You two are the same as ever, huh? There's something weirdly comforting about it.
Ah, Sonia. You seem likewise unchanged.
Even humans can't change in just a couple months. Oh, but there is something I should mention. We have a new friend with us. Let me introduce you to Yuma. Yuma, this is Leston.
Nice to meet you.
Yuma? So, you're the one. You're the vessel of the Shining Dragon, then. I would speak plainly with you. The Shining Dragon's power is a double-edged sword. If wielded improperly, it could just as easily destroy the world as save it. Speak. Are you capable of controlling that power?
Oh, I...
Well, that hardly inspires confidence. Barely an answer at all. Then let me make myself clear. If you ever lose control of your power, I will kill you myself. You seem surprised. If you pose that much of a threat to your own allies, isn't it natural that you should be eliminated?
Brother.
Speak, Kirika.
I will allow no more disrespect to his radiance.
I spoke with no disrespect. It was a statement of fact and nothing more. I've opposed using the Shining Dragon's power from the very beginning. You know this.
I do, and my feelings remain unchanged. His radiance will save Astoria. I'm sure of it.
Well, back to the matter at hand. If you examine this map, you'll note the enemy is gathering at this point in the crags.
I see. All right. If it's around there, I think we can drive them back. They won't cause your unit any trouble.
Our lives are in your hands. We must avoid an ambush from the rear flank at all costs. Now, I should be going. My presence is needed on the front lines.
Understood. Leave the rest to us. We'll be setting out immediately.
He'll kill me? He talks like I don't already know the Shining Dragon is dangerous. But no, I have to show him I can control it. If I work hard and train myself, I know I can do it.
Welcome.
Good stuff here.
Oh?
Please, take this. I would have you keep it close.
What is it?
It's something very precious to me.
If it's that important, are you sure I should be taking care of it?
I believe it belongs in your hands. Please, no more questions for now.
Okay, well, if you trust me that much, then I'll take good care of it.
You have my thanks. Today ended up rather fulfilling. I owe you thanks, I suppose.
It was really fun for me, too.
Really? I treated it rather like another market inspection, so I feared you might have grown bored.
Not at all. I feel like I got to see a different side of the city thanks to you. And I got to see your perspective on it. So now I feel a little closer to you. And that's good, right?
I see. I'm glad you enjoyed it then.
Was I, okay as a guide?
Of course. Truly, it was only thanks to your guidance that I enjoyed myself.
Oh, good. I'm glad.
Yes. So, that said, regarding our next...
Oh, you want to do something like this again?
Yes. Certainly, I'd be happy to accompany you, for the sake of further research.
Okay. I'll do my best then. Hopefully, we can get some more research done.
Oh, I... Why is it so difficult to express these things?
Just a pinch of...
Thank you.
going. How are you?
Excuse me.
I see no problems.
Gotcha!
We've been spotted!
I see you're still awake. Oh, Yuma.
Yay! Hello? What's wrong, Yuma? Did you follow a trail of my feminine pheromones all the way here?
Nope. I just wanted to talk to you.
Yuma, you're hopeless.
Come on, I just got here. What are you calling me out for now?
Listen, okay? You're supposed to say something like,
"Oh, yes, m'lady. I knew that scent would lead me to a beautiful maiden."
You can't just give a serious answer when it's obviously a joke. That's super rude.
Sorry. I'm really not good at small talk.
So, when I tell a joke, you shake your head and say, "Oh, that Rinna." Then the trombone plays, everyone laughs, and I get to say a catchphrase.
What? Who laughs? What's a... Wait, was that a joke too?
Wow, you really are hopeless.
Yeah, sorry.
Sometimes I don't know what I'm going to do with you. You'll never make a good husband like this.
Wait, husband?
I guess I'm just going to have to educate you.
Huh?
Your ultimate training begins now. We're going to chat about absolutely nothing. You'll be a master of small talk in no time. I hope you're ready, because I'm a real strict teacher.
Okay. Just go easy on me, please. She got kind of scary there, but I guess it means she wants to talk to me. So it's probably a good thing.
Tomorrow.
I see.
Enemy approaching.
To me!
Oh!
enemy approaching.
There's a lot of them around here, too. Though it doesn't feel like they're gearing up for an attack.
You're right. It's almost as if...
Kirika, what's wrong?
My chest... It hurts!
Kirika!
M'lady! What's wrong? Lady Kirika!
It's been quite a while, Lady Kirika. Oh, and dear little Rinna, too.
Who's there?
You don't recognize my voice? I suppose 10 years is a lot to ask of anyone's memory. I can't blame you.
10 years? Wait, you mean...
Is that... Beatrice? And the prize goes to Lady Kirika. You know, you've grown so beautiful. Like a blooming flower. Shame you'll have to be plucked. And Rinna, my darling, you're just as I remember you. A pretty little lapdog who never stops yapping. Consider this dose of miasma my personal greeting. I hope it suits your tastes.
Shut up! What do you mean your greeting? You think this is what we wanted?
Careful.
She's gone? M'lady, are you all right?
I think it's fine now.
Guess that spooky miasma stuff doesn't work unless she's around then.
Damn it, that Beatrice. She must have learned some new tricks. Beatrice, where are you? You can't hide.
I'm right here. Why am I here?
Damn, she's fast.
Oh, I don't know about that. Maybe you're all just a little too slow.
What?
Rinna, come back. You're in danger.
But M'lady, she...
There's a good little lapdog. If your master's in danger, you leap right in without any thought to the consequences.
What?
Well, I don't mind. This is our grand reunion, after all. I can play with you for a while.
Yeah!
That's enough playtime for now. I need to be heading back.
You're running away?
I might not look it, but I'm actually on a very tight schedule. I'm supposed to be on a mission right now.
A mission?
That's what I said. Any idea what this is?
It looks like an occultic artifact of some kind. Is something sealed within it?
Sharp as ever, Lady Kirika. And you noticed the most important part. This little number is used to seal away a soul.
What? I won't let you!
Don't get so worked up. It's not your souls I'm after. Besides, I already have the soul of a certain something tucked away in here.
Something? Not the soul of a person, then.
Full marks. Perhaps you've heard of the world dragons?
Of course. The Shining Dragon was part of the World Dragons. They battled Deus 1,000 years ago. Wait, you don't mean...
Very good. Yes, this is a World Dragon soul. I hold the Earth Dragon in the palm of my hand.
What? What are you trying to do?
I wonder. You're free to speculate, though. Whatever you can think of, I assure you, we're doing something worse. Till next time.
Wait, Beatrice!
What? One last parting jab?
Why? Why did you side with the Empire?
Really? That's your question? Isn't it obvious? I want to see Welland burn.
Beatrice! You!
Maybe you'll be around to see it, too. Bye now.
Beatrice! Come back! Beatrice! Stupid Beatrice and her stupid comebacks and her stupid smug face! Oh, but she says stuff like that.
Rinna, what are you doing up this late?
Oh, look! Look, it's Yuma! Hey, Yuma! Won't you sit down and have a little chat with your best friend, huh?
Sure. You're acting a little weird, though. I'm pretty sure that juice isn't even alcoholic. Why are you acting like you're drunk?
Hey, I can get drunk on juice if I want to. Country! I deserve to get drunk after she humiliated me like that!
You mean Beatrice? Kirika seemed like she recognized her too. Who is she?
What, Beatrice? She's a traitor to Welland!
A traitor?
Yep, she tried to steal an harmonic from the treasury, but they caught her red-handed, so she just ran off!
Wow, really?
I mean, I don't know about really. I don't know what actually happened back then. The Beatrice I knew just wouldn't have done something like that. Hey, Yuma?
Yeah?
Yuma, you have such such a nice voice. Let me hear you whisper in my ear. Tell me all about how you feel about me.
What? I thought you were about to say something serious.
I'm super serious. I'm always serious. Ask anyone how serious I am. Anyway, I'm listening.
I'm kind of on the spot here.
Come on, gimme. I want to hear all about your real feelings.
Rinna.
Kirika, a little help?
What is going on down here?
Oh, Lady Kirika? Well, see, I was just thinking it'd be nice to hear Yuma tell me I'm pretty.
I've told you before I will not tolerate disrespect towards his radiance. No more trouble, please. To bed with you.
Kirika, wait!
How may I serve?
What happened between you and Beatrice?
It's not your concern, Your Radiance. Rinna pretends at being drunk to spout whatever she can get away with. It's all in the past now. Rinna and I, we were only children. It no longer matters. Please excuse us, Your Radiance.
Kirika clearly doesn't want to talk about Beatrice. Maybe I should have kept my mouth shut.
So this is the soul of the Earth Dragon.
Yes, you demand, and I supply.
Well done, Beatrice. Fine work indeed.
Oh, I'm sure I couldn't have done it without your precise orders.
She speaks the truth, Princess Excella. Without your guidance, we might have wasted days, resources, manpower.
If you have time for idle flattery, you can continue the search for the Dragon Souls. My powers cannot solve everything. I can only sense their presence if I have an approximate location to work from.
As you command.
Very good. See that the Dragon Soul finds its way to Yoahim. Beatrice, we're leaving.
Yes, Your Highness.
Make sure this gets to Yoahim. Now that I think of it, I haven't seen him around.
Yoahim went to scavenge for Dragon Souls on his own.
What? What is he thinking?
Said he couldn't just sit and wait around anymore. Something about wanting to take his favorite doll for a test run?
Without a single word to me, of course. Academics. And now I need to send someone to chase him down. If he knew we had one of the World Dragon Souls here, I'm sure the man would be tripping over himself to get back.
You need someone to go look for Yoahim? I'll handle it.
You? Let me guess. You just feel like it.
Something like that. I'm going out of my mind cooped up here in the base. A little walk might do me good.
Okay.